Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back to my channel, and I am due to give you guys an update on my tretinoin journey. And this is really the perfect time to do it because I have been using tretinoin now for just a little bit over a year. I started in January 2020, and yeah, definitely due to give you guys an update on where I'm at with my prescription, how my skin is doing, the results that I'm seeing, what I've learned on my journey so far. And I also want to include for you guys in this video my tretinoin routine, you know, the products that I use at night when I incorporate my tretinoin to really kind of help with the side effects. But also I want to show you my post-tretinoin routine the next morning and how I kind of help my skin bounce back and recover. So if you guys are so ready, give the video a big thumbs up and let's get started. So I do get my tretinoin through Curology. Longtime fans may remember I did a sponsored video with Curology back in March of 2020. I'm no longer sponsored by them. This video is not sponsored by them. This video is not even about Curology. It's about my tretinoin journey, but it's really hard for me to talk about my prescription without mentioning that I get it through Curology, right? And I do pay, you know, for my bottles. I go for the 2 month plans, which is about $40 every 2 months. So my prescription is not just tretinoin, it's actually a mixture of three different kind of active ingredients. So it's tretinoin with azelaic acid and niacinamide. My prescription, when I first started in January of 2020, they started me at like the lowest percentage, which is 0.01%. Around, I think it was April of 2020, I requested an upgrade and we went to 0.02%. And I've been so happy with that percentage. I didn't even have thoughts in my mind about going up in percentages at all, because that was a really good amount. I was seeing so many good results with that one. My skin adapted to it. Like, I still got some dryness and dehydration, definitely, but my skin really did adapt to it very nicely. I felt very comfortable in that percentage range for a really long time. I just recently requested an upgrade. My most recent bottle is 0.03%. There's a couple of reasons why I wanted to go to an upgrade, and I just have to like strongly stress to you guys, it's not because there is a specific percentage that you must be at. Like, I'm not trying to push myself and work myself up to, you know, 0.05 or get up to one or whatever. That's not really my goal with tretinoin, and I don't necessarily know that that should be the main goal when you do start your journey with tretinoin. Don't be like a percentage queen or a size queen or anything like that, you know. We are kind of definitely in this environment in the skincare like world where we're always being told by like influencers and brands and marketing and all the information out there that we have to go for proven ingredients at effective amounts and high percentages. And that's just not necessarily the case. You got to listen to your skin and you have to really, yeah, definitely be patient. So anyways, that's my lecture about bigger is not better when it comes to tretinoin. Trust your skin, listen to it, embrace patience on this journey. So I had gotten to a point with my previous percentage, the 0.02%, where I just felt like I had kind of stalled out on the benefits. I was still getting benefits from it, but I just felt like I had made some meaningful progress on some sun damage that I have on my cheeks. It's minor, but it's there. And I was seeing really good benefits when I first started out with my Curology, but I feel like I haven't seen a lot of improvements with it in the last handful of months. I also feel like I've gotten to the point with my prescription where, if you've catched my other tretinoin videos, you know that I like to use a buffering method for my tretinoin to help my skin accept it a little bit better. And I usually mix it in with some moisturizer. And that's a really great way to kind of cut down on some of the dryness, right, and the irritation. And I had gotten to the point where I could put the tretinoin cream directly onto my face. So at that point, I think that my skin had adapted really beautifully to it. I had adapted really beautifully to it. But I was kind of craving maybe a little bit more from my prescription. And so that's why I felt like it was the right time to upgrade to the 0.03% and see how my skin does with it. I always have the option to go back. You know what I mean? If it's just too much, if it's too aggressive, I have that option. I like that flexibility, but I really do want to see what the higher percentage can do, particularly for the sun damage, which is just, it's such a quest, you know, it's something that you need to be patient with and something that takes a lot of time. So here's the results that I've been seeing throughout my year long so far journey on tretinoin. The very first kind of benefit that I started to get from my prescription was much more plump skin, firmer skin. And in fact, it was such a strange sensation. And I know other people who have used tretinoin and retinol in the past have kind of experienced a similar sort of phenomenon where it feels like your skin is actually thicker. You know, like when you're washing your face or something, your skin actually just feels so much thicker and plumper. It's very bizarre, and I mean it in the best way possible. Like your skin is thick, and it's firm and it's bouncy, you know, it just feels amazing. And that's definitely gonna be like with some of that collagen production that's happening. So I definitely noticed that. That was like the first benefit. You know, this specific combination, tretinoin in and of itself can really help with acne and clogged pores, but combining it with azelaic acid, I think, is like that secret sauce for my particular skin, because I am prone to congestion and I do get pimples occasionally. This has really helped keep my skin very clear. Now, I will be honest with you, I do still get pimples from time to time, and there's just so many factors that can go into why you might get a pimple. And a lot of stuff, it's just out of your control. Like hormonal pimples, there's not a lot you can do about that, at least with the topical skincare that you apply, right? But I have noticed like a marked decrease in the pimples that I get, and also a big decrease in just like the clogged pores and the texture. So I've been loving that. That's been amazing for me. And I do think that it kind of helps with pore refinement as well. I don't have like super stretched out pores, but my pores can get quite gunky around my nose, that butterfly kind of area, and my forehead. And I do still get them, but I just feel like it's been better. You know what I mean? I've definitely noticed an improvement. So that's what I've been seeing with it so far. As far as fine lines and wrinkles, I think it has made some improvements. I think where I've seen the biggest improvement, now I'm still relatively young, you know, I do have fine lines around my under eye area. I can't really get my tretinoin all the way up there because it's a little bit more of a sensitive area. You probably don't want to get tretinoin there, but I do have the nasolabial fold, you know, that just this crease here that everybody has. I did notice before I was starting tretinoin that it was starting to get a little bit maybe more noticeable, maybe a little deeper. Since I've been on the prescription, I do think there's been an improvement in that area. I don't think it's placebo effect. I do think that this has been plumped up and smoothed out quite a bit. And so I'm very happy about that. So now I just want to share with you a typical nighttime routine that includes my tretinoin prescription. Because I really do believe if you craft that routine where you're using your tretinoin in a smart way, you can really cut down on a lot of the side effects, the dryness, the dehydration, the irritation, the redness. You can significantly cut down on that if you craft your routine in a really smart manner. And I'm going to show you like the typical routine that I would do with my tretinoin. I do have another video as well about fighting the side effects of tretinoin. So if you're on that tretinoin journey, I will link that in the info box for you guys. But I'm going to share my typical nighttime routine, and then I'm going to come back in the morning and show you how to really get your skin to bounce back after using tretinoin, because you can wake up the next morning feeling a little bit more dry, a little bit more tight, a little itchy, a little irritated. And so I want to show you a typical morning routine to just really kind of like help your skin bounce back and feel really moisturized and healthy and comfortable. So let's go. Okay, so I just washed up, and before I tell you what cleansers I use, I am going to go in for the Misha Time Revolution, the Artemisia Treatment Essence. This is the mist version. And I'm going to put on my face because it's starting to dry out while I'm talking to you. So I did do a double cleanse since I was wearing some makeup earlier. So I used the Hada Labo Gokujan Oil Cleanser. And then I went in for my second cleanser, which is the First Aid Beauty Pure Skin Face Cleanser. The Misha Essence that I just used. Now, I really like this because Artemisia, or
mugwort is very calming and soothing to the skin. So it's a great way to start off this tretinoin-centric routine. And because this is a first essence, this is actually going to help all the other skincare that I use tonight really penetrate and absorb into my skin a lot better. So now I'm going to replenish my skin with toner. I love a good hydrating toner. Really great way to get lots of hydration and lots of balance into your skin before we go in for tretinoin. So this is from Make Preem. This is their Save Me Relief Essence Toner. So I do a couple layers of toner. You know this. You know I love a couple skins of toner. And really, you know, it's just about listening to what your skin wants and needs in the moment. And really starting off with like a very, you know, simple, gentle, hydrating product like this toner from Make Preem. It's really a great way to start off your tretinoin routine because it's gonna give your skin that kind of like foundation of hydration that's really gonna help your skin accept the tretinoin a lot better. So, you know, this routine is all about packing the skin with lots of hydration, lots of moisture, and lots of barrier supportive ingredients, really kind of leading up to getting that tretinoin onto the skin. One of my like favorite products, like so reliable, like this will not fail you for moisture, it is Laneige Cream Skin Refiner. This stuff just packs a nourishing, rich, silky punch to my skin. The kind of punch you want to your skin, you know what I mean? I just feel so good about this. Like I just love enveloping my skin with this creamy, silky, rich goodness. I'm in love with it. It feels great. It feels fantastic right after toner too. I kind of use this like a pseudo essence because it doesn't quite work for me after serums. I don't know why it just doesn't, but I just really like it in between toner and serum. It just like balances my skin. It feels light and yet once it absorbs into your skin, it just goes with moisture. Like it just fills out your skin with moisture. And really, honestly, one layer is all that I really need, which is quite surprising because, you know, I like to layer my toner and essence type products, but really just one layer. And my skin just feels so balanced, so comfortable, so moisturized. Feel free to layer this up though if you do need more. It really is about paying attention to what your skin needs in the moment and really kind of honing your skin intuition. So my lips are actually feeling a little bit dry. I'm just gonna put a layer of Aquaphor healing ointment on them. This is actually a nice tip for you guys with tretinoin as well because I did make the mistake of getting a little tretinoin like on my lip line and it kind of caused like a major problem for me. So this is actually a great way to kind of keep your lips protected or any area you don't want to get tretinoin in, you can put a little layer of Aquaphor or Vaseline or the CeraVe healing ointment in that area. I'm going just a little bit over my lips too. I am a little bit chapped this winter as well and this helps. But because this is such an occlusive protective layer, it's gonna help ensure that I don't get tretinoin accidentally onto my lips. So now that I've really gotten a layer of deep hydration into my skin and a layer of nice moisture, I can kind of move on and start thinking about barrier support. This is something that I focus in on a lot of the times, not just for tretinoin, but just for general skin health, right? But it is particularly important to pack your tretinoin routine with barrier supportive ingredients because when you keep your moisture barrier strong, your skin is going to be able to accept your prescription a lot better. And that means less side effects. So this is definitely a really crucial step to keep in mind as you build your own tretinoin routine. Now, I know I've used this serum in other routines that are focused on tretinoin, but I mean, if it's not broke, don't fix it, right? So I'm gonna go in for the R&W Ceramide Plus Serum. What I like about this, there's a variety of different ceramides in here, plus skin reparative peptides. And I particularly like the texture of this as well. The results are also very good. This definitely keeps my skin in very good shape, my moisture barrier very strong, and that just absorbed so quickly into my skin. My skin just like sucked it up. It really does have such a pleasing texture. So now it's time for eye cream. And you know, when I first started my tretinoin journey, when my prescription was at 0.01%, I actually was able to put my prescription under my eye area and on top of my eyelids with no problems whatsoever. And you know, in my mind, I was thinking, I really want that collagen stimulation and those anti-aging benefits around my eye area, because that really is the area where you start to see the signs of aging first. And I do have some fine lines there. I want to keep that area nice and smooth. However, when I did the upgrade to the 0.02% of tretinoin, you know, can't handle it. Can't handle it anymore. My eyelids got super duper sore and raw, and it was really painful. So I stopped doing that, and I avoid that area at all costs now. But I am still interested in stimulating collagen in my eye area, which is why I have started to incorporate a retinol eye cream into my routine. This is from First Aid Beauty. And I really like this formulation because they have kind of buffered out the retinol with other barrier supportive ingredients, which is really kind of the same thing that we're doing with this, you know, full face skincare routine. We're really strengthening the moisture barrier and keeping it strong so that the skin can accept the tretinoin or the retinol a lot better. Another area where you might want to use a retinol eye cream is actually your neck. Now, I can get tretinoin, at least at my current prescription, onto my neck without irritation or peeling or dryness. Not everybody can. But if you still want that collagen stimulating benefit on the neck, I'd actually suggest trying I would look for a affordable one, definitely, because you'll go through the tube a little bit faster, but try an eye cream with retinol on your neck because they are formulated to be a lot more gentle. So if you've watched any skincare routine, even just one other skincare routine from me, you know that I always use Stradia Liquid Gold right now, right? It's just one of those products that I trust so much, and then it's just done so much for my skin over the years. It's all about moisture barrier care. It's ceramides, cholesterol, fatty acids. There's some niacinamide in here. So something that I like to do with my liquid gold is mix in some facial oil, especially if you're fighting dryness and even irritation. Facial oil can bring a lot of relief to your skin. And I like to mix them together because it keeps the layer a little bit lighter and more easy to absorb. So tonight I'm going to be using the Tamanu oil from So Long. So I just mix them together on the back of my hand like that and then just apply straight to the face. Now, Tamanu oil is nice because it actually has some nice skin brightening benefits to it. It can really work on hyperpigmentation. It does have some good evidence for working on like acne scars, and it's got a really good skin repairing ability. So it's actually really good if you are suffering with a little bit of irritation to use some Tamanu oil in your skincare routine. You can really use any oil you like, but I particularly like the effects of this one. Okay, and now the main event, tretinoin time. You know, there's a couple of different ways that you can apply your tretinoin cream. You can put it on right before moisturizer in a thin layer all over your face. You can mix it into your moisturizer, kind of similar to what we did with the oil. That's going to keep the layer a little bit lighter, but it's also going to help it absorb into the skin better. And it's a great buffering method if you find that putting it directly onto your skin like this is going to cause some irritation. This is a good way to just like help your skin accept it better. Now, if you're ultra sensitive and you're just having a hard time with it, put a layer of moisturizer on, put your tretinoin on top of that. So the moisturizer that I'm going to go with, you know, I've cycled through a lot of different moisturizers. The one that I'm currently using and like for tretinoin nights is an old favorite. It's the CeraVe Moisturizing Cream. This is a classic for a reason. It just works, right? And why I really like this for tretinoin nights is because it's got ceramides, cholesterol, fatty acids. I'm actually going to put a layer of moisturizer around my eyes first. And this is going to help, kind of like what we did with the Aquaphor. It's just gonna make sure that I don't go over my eyes. And if I do, I have kind of like a layer of protection around that area already. So I like to put my tretinoin on mixed into my moisturizer. I can sometimes get away with a light layer underneath moisturizer, but the side effects of that do tend to be a little bit more intense for me. And because the weather is just so harsh, I don't want to deal with any more dryness than I need to. So I'm going to just mix in a little pump of my Curology into the CeraVe moisturizer. So you really don't need a lot. You want to be restrained with the amount that you are using. Now, something else that has been helping me out quite a bit, especially like I said, with increased dryness in the winter time, is to just put a little bit more. This was just like some excess moisturizer. Just put a little bit more in. At least for me personally, I have problem areas, which is really my cheeks and my chin. So I'm not really going to put any extra moisturizer. I don't really feel like I need it on my forehead. Everybody's different though, so just make sure you're listening to your skin on this one. But I just put another little extra layer on top. It's like sandwiching in the tretinoin. I will bring up one more product that you might want to consider having around in your like skincare arsenal when it comes to tretinoin. The La Roche-Posay Cicaplast B5 cream. This stuff is really great. And you can use this as a sleeping pack. So you can put this all over your face right after your moisturizer to just kind of give yourself that little extra occlusivity, that little extra moisture, and some really great irritation relief. It's great at fighting dehydration. You can use this on your off nights from tretinoin when you're kind of dealing with maybe some of the extra dryness that comes along with tretinoin application. I'm not actually gonna put this all over my face tonight because, as I said, my skin actually feels really good right now, but let me tell you. I've said this a lot on my channel. You know, wearing masks has made this area here right around my mouth and chin just a lot more susceptible to irritation and dryness. And then applying tretinoin on top of that, this area is just a little bit extra right now. It just needs a little extra TLC. So feel free, if you're just like me and having a little bit of extra problems in just one specific area, to just take a little bit of the cream and just put it where you need it. You know, you don't have to feel like you have to go for a full face application. I can tell you, if I put any more moisturizing, nourishing layers on my forehead, I'm gonna start to get a little congested. All right, I'm done. I'm glazed, I'm glowing. My skin feels great and I'm ready for bed. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna change, hop into bed, and I will meet you right back here tomorrow morning because I'm gonna show you an example of a routine that helps my skin bounce back from any tretinoin side effects that I might have gotten. All right, good morning. So I just washed my face right away and I just use water and a washcloth. I don't use any cleansing products in the morning, and that is for a couple of reasons. You know, I do have dehydrated skin that's quite sensitive, and with the tretinoin, that does tend to make things a little bit more amplified, right, with the dryness and the dehydration. So just cleansing with water and skipping the cleanser helps me maintain as much moisture on my skin as possible. So just like last night, I am gonna go in for some layers of hydration. I think three layers, which is what this is, the third layer right now, is all that my skin is really going to need for the day. All right, time for serum. And you know, you can definitely just keep using the same serum morning to nighttime. And actually, that's really probably the best thing to do because then you're going to see some really consistent results on your skin. But just for the sake of showing a different option with serum, and because I particularly like the texture of this one and what it brings to my skin, I do want to go in for the Inkeylist Q10 serum this morning. It's actually quite creamy. And this is another kind of product that like envelops your skin with non-greasy moisture and just makes it feel comforted and soothed just from the texture. And it's such a great ingredient too to just kind of like help support your well-aging journey or your anti-aging journey, because this is something that can really help to firm up the skin, really help aid the elasticity of your skin, and it's got all that antioxidant power too. So it's a nice choice for the morning time to kind of help boost your UV protection. So I'm just going to go in for a creamy moisturizing eye cream from Hyunkaenyul. This is the Black Tea Time Reverse Eye Cream. There's some nice peptides in here. It has some barrier supportive ingredients too, which is good if you do tend to get just like maybe a little bit of extra dryness from maybe using a retinol type of product around your eye area. This can kind of help that delicate area bounce back and also just kind of help keep it strong in the long run. Okay, so I am going to go in for Liquid Gold again this morning. You know, I don't always use this in the morning time, but definitely the morning after tretinoin, it's a good time to use it in the morning. And I'm also going to go in for the Tamanu Oil again, just about three drops. So now it's time for moisturizer, and kind of like with the serum step, you can just kind of keep using the same moisturizer. The CeraVe Moisturizing Cream with all those ceramides, cholesterol, fatty acids is an excellent choice morning or nighttime. But again, for the sake of just kind of showing something a different option for you guys, and one that I also think is great for use alongside of your tretinoin, this is the Curel Moisture Cream. And this actually has quite a similar texture to the CeraVe, but it's just a little bit different ingredients list. And I actually quite like this if I am suffering with a little bit of irritation, because there is like a nice calming quality to this. And this actually seems to kind of also help with redness as well. It's just a really great sensitive skin type of moisturizer. Not that CeraVe isn't, but like I said, this is just another different choice that you could go for. And it really just has that nice kind of calm down quality to it, which I find nice the morning after using tretinoin. And finally, but really crucially, sunscreen. So today I'm going to be using the Isntree Hyaluronic Acid Watery Sun Gel. This is a chemical sunscreen, SPF 50 PA plus 4. And I've been liking this one a lot. You know, really, sunscreen, it's a personal journey. It's a quest to find the one that works for you. It's incredibly individual. So just stick with ones that work for your skin, that you like, that fit your lifestyle. This is one that just feels really nice and breathable on my skin. It's not super thick. It works nicely with makeup. And it doesn't leave any type of white cast on my skin, which I really, really like. All right, and that's it. We're all done. I hope you guys enjoyed that look at my, you know, tretinoin journey so far for 1 year. And also, I hope you enjoyed the routines, because I find that to be a really crucially important part of your tretinoin journey is really just figuring out the right mix of products to keep your skin healthy and strong and happy. Because all kinds of weird stuff can happen to your skin, especially when you're first starting. So hopefully the PM and AM routines kind of gave you some inspiration for your tretinoin journey. And you know, if you're watching this video, maybe you are in a tretinoin journey or not. I'm actually curious to know, what do you incorporate into your routine to help with your well aging or anti-aging journey? I'm curious to know. So let me know in the comment box below. If you love the video and it was helpful for you, but you haven't hit subscribe yet, please don't go before considering hitting that subscribe button. I release 2 new skincare focused videos every single week, and then turn on those notifications so you don't miss out when I upload the new videos throughout the week. I hope you guys are having a fantastic morning or night wherever you are in the world. I hope that you are healthy, happy, and safe, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.